Hello, I am back. Yes, we have just witnessed the genocide of the Doma Kingdom with the poisoning of Doma Castle at the hands of Kefka, and we met up with Cyan as we was playing as Saban, and now we're making our way south through the eastern part of the world here to try and get our way back to Nash to help out with Returnals with whatever stuff it is that they're doing. So what we need to do is we just need to head south, and there's a little bridge here. You can head eastward to get to Doma Castle, which I'll just show you. But I don't think we can do anything in there, because it's just swarming with... it's just swarming with Imperial Guards. Yeah. So now that we have Sion, we've got a bit more firepower in our arsenal, so... essentially the routine you're going to do is... Aura Cannon with Sabin... throw with Shadow and level one Kushido with Cyan. My job is done. I've earned my pay. Shit. When was the last time I saved? It was way back. I was hoping I would have had Shadow for the rest of this, and this is me not saving that's caused the problem. Right, well, that's a bit of a shame, actually, because this next section is a lot easier with Shadow. But alas, he's run away with all our stuff. Well, there's nothing I can do about it now, because if I reload, I'll be back to the start of it. I'll be back to the start of the last part, so let's not do that. Let's just try make do with Cyan and Sabin here. But yes, if you come to Doma Castle, it's just filled with Imperial Guards, so... Let me throw down a save right now. I'll save over to... Let me just double check that load. Quick save. Yeah. I'm just going to go back to the main menu. I'm just going to double check that load. Yep. Shit. Rough, man. Rough. Yeah, that's the problem. That's the problem with it, because essentially what I've done there is we've robbed ourselves of what? Per turn, 600 damage. It's ridiculous. Man. I will admit, that's a bit of an annoying mechanic. A bit of an annoying thing about this section of the game is that Shadow just goes away. Oh well, nothing we can do about it. Absolutely nothing we can do about it. So, well, stop complaining, Tapers. I've been abandoned by one of my friends. Most literally, you can have... Shadow with you for the entirety of the rest of this section, but no. Well, until you get to a certain point. But it's this next section that I wanted him. We'll be alright, we'll be fine. There we go. Devised a new blitz technique. Ah, this is going to be very useful. I also need to learn how to do it. So, if I look at ability, Sabin, let's, right, so it goes, left, left, down, right, right, left, left, down, right, right, I think, yeah, we'll try that, because that is actually Sabin's multi-target attack, which is really powerful, so, if we come across any enemies, I'll give it a go. Yes, this is the Phantom Forest. You need to go a specific route through here from what I know. Ooh, Recovery Spring. That's handy. Maybe a bit. Because I think this place is... let me just try it just so I know it. There you go. Yeah, that's it. But that hits everything on screen, or every enemy on screen, so really powerful for this next part coming up. But this place is interesting in that if you go the wrong way, it sends you back to the start. But it's really simple, you just need to go up. Oh shit. Man, these guys hit like a freight train, don't they? No, it should kill everything. Essentially, the way I look at it is you just sort of need to go, like, down... Like, you don't need to go... you don't need to do anything too fancy. You just go down from the first place. And then, you see the train in the background? Just go towards the train. And here we are.
A train. I thought all of Doma's railways had been destroyed in the fighting.
There could be survivors. Let's take a look inside.
Okie dokie.
Hey! Looks like we can get in through here.
Sir Sabin.
We can't just wander around out here all day. We have to check inside.
Sir Sabin!
Don't worry, it'll only take a second.
Sir Sabin!
Yeah, this train doesn't look too friendly. It's like the Polar Express. Only without snow.
What in the world?
We must leave at once. This is the Phantom Train.
It's moving.
We must get off this train at once.
The door won't open.
I fear we are too late.
What did you say this train was?
This is the Phantom Train. It carries the souls of the departed to their final destination.
Wait a second. You're saying this train's giving us one-way ride to the afterlife?
Unless we find a way off. I'm afraid that is exactly where we will end up.
Well, I'm afraid that's a trip I'm going to have to pass on.
If it won't let us off, then we'll stop it ourselves. Let's make for the engine.
Hello, Raz. Welcome back, and have you too. How are you doing, friend? Why did I come back to hearing again, the impression? That's because you have been introduced to Cyan, who is our samurai friend. Who just had his entire family and kingdom wiped out by Kefka. Right, but here we are on the Phantom Train. I could have done with the firepower that Shadow provides to you, but we'll be okay, I think. Oh, not a bomb. These guys are assholes. As long as I kill them, we're alright. Because those guys explode and just do a shit ton of damage. They're not nice things. Right, and I've got plenty of potions. Yeah, the reason why I'm being a bit antsy about not having Shadow around is that having only two characters doesn't give me a lot of flexibility. Oh, hello! Save point, don't mind if I do. It doesn't give me a lot of flexibility in terms of healing up or whatever during a fight.
Ah, Miss Train's conductor. What business brings you here?
Tell us about the train.
The Phantom Train ferries the souls of the departed to the other side. Once the souls arrive, they are granted their eternal rest.
How do we stop this thing?
You want to stop the train? Search every corner of the engineer's compartment. I'm sure there's a way.
Might these be timetables?
These, huh? They're all blank.
This train carries the dead to the afterlife. It's a little tough to be making timetables of as much conflict in the world as there is right now.
Yeah, people die, man. Right, okay, let's, get on with getting through here. Excuse me. Oh, this ghost is a bloody troll. Out of the way. Yeah, it's very dangerous because a lot of the enemies here can do a metric ton of damage. Thankfully, with the haste on Sabin, though, not too many attacks should get out. Hopefully, should mitigate a lot of damage. There we go. And the simple thing is just keep going left, and you should get to where you need to be eventually. That's how trains work. Let's see if this Rising Phoenix will just defeat everything here. Oh, those little things flying around the screen are like little mini Sabins. That's cool. Or hot, should I say, because it looks like fire. Oh, dear me. I'm trying not blowing my face off so much. Oh, man, the bloody... These are probably the worst enemies, to be honest. Like, they just took half of Cyan's health just because it wanted to. Wait, does that drop me back in the train? Screw you, game. Yeah, we should be okay. What's in here, though? I wanna see what's in there! There we go, did it cook enough? We gotta be quick to beat that guy. Gotta be quick off the draw. Angel Whisper. Well, at least we're one-shotting everything. This gives me hope. Actually, come to think of it, having the multi-target attack from Sabin makes Shadow less important, I feel. It's just good to have the... It's just good to have an extra health pool, you know? Such a cool attack. How was going out today, though, Raz? Is the world okay? Nice and sunny? Oh, bloody... Get out of the way. Oh, hello. Actually, before I talk to this guy. No escape. What have I got planned this afternoon? The Formula One is on this afternoon. I'll be watching the Austrian Grand Prix. And then, depending if the weather remains the way it is, I should probably do a bit of gardening. Move on, put up some weeds, you know. Got some gardening loves. Because our front little patch of flower bed is a bit looking a bit nasty. The race starts at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, UK time. The build up starts at 1, but the race is at 2. Ooh, what do you suppose that was all about? No escape, huh? Uh oh, no escape. Who is there? It came from over here. The greater good. They're coming after us. Uh-oh. Yep, go up the ladder. I think they got a bit annoyed at me telling them to move and getting angry at them. I don't blame them. Nowhere to run. Nowhere to hide. No escape for you. They just don't let up. Right, okay.
I believe we have reached a dead end, Sir Sabin. Alright. Hast thou an idea?
Yes. The time has come to put my training to use. Come, Cyan.
Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Right, okay. Let's continue on. Oh, Aaron's coming to see Harvey at 2:30. Could pop over for an hour if you want. Show the whip and see Harvey if not planning on going out. I think me and Tasha just want an afternoon sort of to ourselves because this weekend's been a bit full on with seeing people, so we're looking to keep the Sunday afternoon just between me and her. I will come over and see that new whip though, don't you worry. Yeah. Don't you worry, I will come over and see that new shiny car of yours. I wonder if it's the same inside as Tasha's. Oh, mate, this new car fiasco. I went in Tasha's car the other day, and because it's brand new, I thought I kept my car clean, okay? I thought it was nice and shiny on the inside. Went into Tasha's and went back into mine. It was like, I need some wet wipes and some glass cleaner because my car is not looking so hot on the inside right now. Needs a good Hoover, too. Hey. They couldn't still be. They just don't let up. We'll have to detach for your cars. Alright, I think there's a button around here somewhere. Yeah, this thing. Right, be gone, evil spirits. But aren't most guys supposed to be ferried to the afterlife? We've kind of just stopped them from getting to the afterlife. That's a bit rude.
That should be the end of that.
Right, but we do need to get into this carriage. So I think we'll flip the switch again. And the door opens. I don't even know what sort of damage these guys are going to do. There, yeah, I don't think Cyan can one-shot those guys, so I'm a Rising Phoenix. Just everything Rising Phoenix. Right, okay. Onwards! To the left! I think we should one-shot everything. Poor Cyan here is a bit of a third wheel at this point, isn't he? Just like slashing these ghosts and then Sabin comes in and annihilates everything. Oh, this is an interesting little place, actually.
Please be seated if you wish to order.
Yeah, what you can do here, this effectively acts as a spring.
Food! Bring me everything you've got.
He starts smashing his hands together. Yeah, this acts as a spring because this heals all your MP and HP.
Is this strange food truly safe to eat? What are you worried about? We can't wage war on an empty stomach. Do what thou wilt, sir. I'm sure there is no stopping thee.
Indeed, I was every nom 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 nom. There we go. And you can do that as many times as you want.
Oh, I'm stuffed. Shall we get moving?
Yeah, that fills up your entire... you can do it as many times as you want and it just fills up all your HP and MP, so very handy. Particularly with these assholes about. I don't know if there's a chance of them using explode when you kill them, or if they just do it at random. I'm getting earring. That could be useful for Sabin, actually. It might increase his normal damage with his blitzers, that's the one. Oh, there's a chest in here.
Yeah, hold it right there. I am Siegfried, the greatest swordsman in all the world, and that treasure belongs to me. If I were you, you over-muscled moose, I'd grab Grandpa there and run away while you still can.
Greatest windbag is more like it. You're the one who had best beat a brave retreat.
What? Brazen words for a man about to be spitted upon by my blade like a plump and juicy pig. On guard! Here I come! You kids better get ready! Hiya!
And he gets black belted by Sion. Oh dear. What a guy.
Hold back and no bite.
No, it cannot be! But the last laugh belongs to me! Ah, see? The treasure is mine! Au revoir, my friends!
What a jerk. There's a way that I can catch him.
I want my loot!
I guess not. Is he on the train? He's probably like hiding somewhere, like right at the back of a train, isn't he?
You want to stop the train? Search every corner of the engineer's compartments. I'm sure there's a way.
Ooh, chests! Don't mind if I do, I'll just have a drink first. Ooh. Sniper Eye is another relic. I don't know if it's got that much use. I think it just guarantees that you never miss. Yeah, a physical attack never misses. And the mandatory monster in a box. Oh god, this is a strong enemy. There we go. Woo! A floating health pool! We got Hyper to start the deal, so that's okay. There's a bomb inside! Is that legal? You've not taken any damage. Why are you using drain? Oh, that heals these guys. Whoops. I guess it does fire damage then. I'll keep that in mind in future. Well, it dealt with the two little shits on the bottom at least. This is a nasty fight, actually. Oh, what's in here? A save point? Yes! That's handy. It means I don't have to go all the way back. This is the engineer's compartment.
We've got to find a way to stop this thing. Fast!
Something's written here.
To stop the train, shut the first and third pressure valves, then throw the switch located by the smokestack.
Yes, first and third. This one. And this one. And a random encounter. With three bombs, of course.
Thank you.
Okay, cool. It didn't get an explode off, fantastic. And there's one thing I want to check before I flip the switch on the smokestack, because this triggers the final boss battle, by the way. But if I first and foremost heal up, and then come down to ability stab and blitzes. I want to check this and that. Right, left, down, up. Because
the train should stop if we throw this switch. So, you're the ones who've been slowing me down.
Yes. All these years of watching Thomas the Tank Engine, and now I shall get my revenge. Eventually. Behold! Suplexing a train like WWE. Yes, you can suplex a train in this game. Oh boy, I think we even did that on the speedrun. Like, take that, Thomas the Tank Engine. Oh, Acid Rain, that doesn't look like it'd be helpful. Healthy. Raz says, I've got no idea what's going on in this game. Effectively, all the party members are gathering in a place called Nash to decide what to do about the evil empire. We're currently doing Sabin's part of the story here, who got separated from the main group and ended up on the eastern side of the planet. And now he wants to get back to the rest of the party, but in his adventure, we picked up Cyan. And to get to the place where the rest of the party is, we need to go through this haunted forest, where this train apparently operates.
I will let you go, but first there is something I must do.
And also a lot of beating the shit out of things on the way. JRPGs, man. So essentially we just kicked a train's ass. I mean, that is just so absurd, isn't it? That's an annoying train whistle.
It seems we have arrived. Whew. Glad to be off that thing. The faster we leave our train behind, the better.
Ah, this is brutal.
Is that Elaine? Owen! Cyan, was that your wife and son? The train's leaving. Please wait. Elaine, Owen.
My love, you made me so happy. Thank you. Dad, I'll keep practicing with my sword so I can keep Mama safe.
That's so brutal. Kefka's a massive dick. Yeah, but the story behind that, Raz, is a while ago, earlier in the stream, Kefka, who is a absolute psychopath, poisoned the drinking water of the entire kingdom of Doma, which is where Cyan's from, and it killed everyone in Doma, effectively, including Cyan's wife and son. So that, and that was the Phantom Train, which takes people from death to afterlife. That's why they got on it. Particularly brutal. Right, okay, and let's head up north. Because there's one thing we need to do, and that is, One of the more cooler things in this game is at Baron Falls.
This must be Baron Falls. To the south of here lies the Veldt. It is a wild and dangerous land, inhabited by all manner of ferocious beasts.
Bloody Sion tickles my throat, man.
So if we turn around and go back, the Empire will be waiting for us. The village of Moblis lies on the eastern coast. If we can make it through the Veldt, we could head there.
First things first, before I even think about jumping off this waterfall here, fully heal. And then dive into the falls. Yes. This is so cool. Like, that's a huge waterfall. I'm just going to jump in it. But this also starts off a... a chain of events where this is essentially just a gauntlet run now. Like, a shit ton of enemies. Where the fights don't stop now. You can't heal between now and the final boss of this section. So this is like a really nasty gauntlet run. And that's why I suggested healing before he jumped off of here. Oh, shit. Can't afford too many of those. Incorrect blitz command is really harsh. that's because, like, with the commands which need you to do diagonal stuff, sometimes it registers correct, sometimes it doesn't. So it's one of those things you've got to factor in. Uh-oh, it was down, down, left I was supposed to do. Should be able to deal with this guy with relative ease. It's at this point that Shadow would normally leave you, though. Once you get to the top of Baron Falls, no matter what, he will leave. So at this point, missing Shadow's not a thing. Oh, and we got a remedy and 3 potions. Here we are. At the bottom of Baron Falls, floating down the river. Just around the river bend, I look once more. Oh, hello. What a strange character. A youth draped in monster hides, his eyes shining with a warm and gentle light. This is Gao, who has been hotboxing or whatever's going on with his pink eyeballs. Bit nervous around other people, it seems. But we are now on the Veldt. And this is where I was, actually, I'll wait until we come across Gao again before I explain a bit more. But what the Veldt is, it's not necessarily an area with specific enemies. But as you go through the game and you encounter formations of enemies, like earlier once I encountered a formation of 3 stray cats or wherever in the world. Once you encounter them anywhere else, they will then be able to show up in the Veldt, so I should be able to encounter stray cats or any enemy in the game on the Veldt, apart from boss battles, I think. So, the Veldt is very dangerous, because there are some difficult enemies that you can come across on here, but the reason why that is a thing is because it involves a mechanic with Gao, which we'll see a little bit later on. So that's how the felt works, is that the enemies from all around the world in the game end up on the felt. Like these guys. If you remember from Mount Colts. Who are massive pushovers, so it's not that big a deal. But what I'm doing is I'm just heading over to the east, because there is a village over there. And I love the music of the belt for some reason, it's just so kind of catchy. Yeah, this should kill everything. Oh no, it only goes in one direction. I see. I thought it did everything on screen. Same result anyways. An enemy died. But yeah, thankfully a lot of the enemies we've met are kind of pushovers at the moment. But it's just once you come across some that are a bit more difficult. That we've faced recently. Like, a lot of the ghost enemies are the tough ones. But yes, there's a village up here which we can go to. A village or a town. This is when I should use Rising Phoenix, but I didn't. But it's only stray cats though, so we're okay. Man, a counter-attack with Cyan doesn't actually kill the stray cat. Must have about 200 health or something. Right, let's enter. I won't say let's enter this village, but the felt had other ideas. Oh shit, this guy's actually kind of tough. If you remember, this was the guy that was in the monster in a box at the Imperial camp. Oh, don't attack that one, Cyan. There we go. Yeah, that's why it's so dangerous, because it rages. It rages your player, your characters, so you don't get control over them. So you don't retain control over them. And if it keeps sounding an alarm, it's just going to destroy your face. But we got another Green Beret, which is actually really useful. Let's actually, I think we can equip those, can't we? Yeah, I've already got one on Sabin. Brilliant, right, let's get into town before anything else tries and kills us. And this is Mobblers.
You came now, man, Falls. Unbelievable. It's flowing even stronger than usual this year. No one's been able to get here lately.
Is it true that war has broken out? I got a letter saying that it had.
Carrier pigeons are our only link to the outside world.
Oh.
Did you see the house on the far northern plains? That old man has lost his marbles. They say he threw out his own kid, thinking he was some kind of monster.
That's harsh.
This region's known as the Felt. Monsters migrate here from all over the world, so it can be quite dangerous outside of town. Never know what you might run into.
Right, there's an inn here. I might rest here, actually, depending on how much it is.
Rooms are 100 gil per night.
No, I'm not mistaken. Actually, I think there's a way around stopping at the inn here, which I shall investigate. just to get this blinded ailment or whatever it is off of my, off of these two. Is it sleep? I'm not too sure what ailment is. Shit, what I can do is, I was gonna say equipment with the ribbon, but I don't have it on me. Shit. Not too big a deal. There's some houses here. Oh, weapons, weapons. Let's buy some weapons. Right, what do we need? Kotetsu for Cyan. Mithril Claws for Salmon. And no other weapons are really better than what we already have equipped on the other party members. So I guess a big thing for us now is armor. Right, Magus Heart for our two mages. Bandana. I don't know what's better. Yeah, I'll get one of these for Gao. I'm going to get two of these. I'm not too worried about putting iron armor on Celis or Terra. One, two, three, four. How many do I have of these? Two. Get another three. There we go. There, that should keep us going. We'll just equip some of these on. Yeah, put the Kotetsu on Cyan. Leather art. Yeah, I'll stick the iron armor on. Gives us more defense, so can't really complain. And there's nothing really for stabbing. Right, perfect. That should be. That bumps us up a bit. One of the main things I know about Final Fantasy VI is you want to go for better gear more than anything. Like, keep your gear up to scratch and you'll not have many problems. Out hunting yesterday, I could have sworn I saw a kid running along with a pack of monsters. What if it was just my overactive imagination? Underdoggo. I threw some dry meat to herd hungry animals last time I was out on the felt. And would you believe it? Some kid scrambled out of a herd and ran off of it. That's giving you a hint on what you need to do with this particular part of the game. Buy some dried meat. It's important. Actually, cures an empty stomach. I don't know how much it heals, actually. Expensive, though. Anything else I need? Phoenix Downs we're okay with. I think I'm okay for the moment being. It's not like there's a shortage of stores in this game, so we're good. What's this guy doing over here?
Powerful ocean currents run through the Serpent Trench. Have you ever heard about them?
No. And this gives you a hint as to what you're supposed to do. Right, if you look at the map, it's essentially saying that the way to get back to Nash is to swim. Like, past Doma. And then up to that place.
I've never occurred, and you'd be swept straight to Nikea. Too bad our only diving helmet was stolen.
That doesn't sound very safe. I can't imagine that being a very an approved way of getting transported around. Yeah, just jump in the water and follow the current like Finding Nemo.
Let me know if you need anything. I can send letters and packages to any corner of the world for you.
And what is in your basement? Or is this like the post office?
The entrance to the Serpent Trent lies within Crescent Mountain, near the southern tip of a continent.
Yeah, cool. Yeah, it's giving us hints on where we need to go.
Right. Is everything in here?
The soldier inside this house is hurt real bad. Someone says we have to keep our voices down. Shh. You have to be quiet.
Except a guy, man. Why is there a woman stood in the trees?
Yeah.
That's a bit creepy.
A grievously injured soldier wandered into the village not too long ago. I dressed his wounds, but his condition doesn't seem to be improving. Those letters coming from the town of Marana are the only things keeping him going.
Hello.
I'm a soldier from Marana. When our town fell to the Empire, I was forced to join the Imperial Army. I tried to flee rather than help them attack Doma, but they came after me. I barely escaped alive. Now I can't even move. I'll never see Lola again. There's a letter on my desk. Would you be kind enough to bring it to me?
It tears it up. No, of course.
There are even more Imperial soldiers walking the streets of Miranda these days. But things are peaceful otherwise. The flowers in the garden will soon bloom and announce the arrival of spring. How are you doing? I'm worried. I so wish that I could fly to your side and be with you. Please only think about getting better. Try not to push yourself too hard. Rest, knowing that I spend every day thinking only of you and wishing I could see you. Lola.
I'd like to write back, but I don't even have the strength to pick up a pen.
Well, I could write for you. Does anyone have a pen?
Biro Black, please.
Right, but what we can do is we can go to the post office again and speak to the guy.
So you want to send a letter to Lola for the injured soldier?
Yeah.
And he sends out a letter. We'll go back to the guy. I don't know if he sees anything.
I want to get better so I can return to Miranda. I want to see Lola.
Hang in there, man. Just rest and get your strength back. That's the most important thing you can ever do. Right, and we can come up here. There's a lady.
Dwayne and Katarine are both 16. Ah, what a magical age. The springtime of love.
I suppose she's referring to these two staring at each other. Right. Young love. Right, and there's this house here. I think this is a relic shop. We can buy a white kit for 5,000. What does it even do? Prevents imp and silence. Don't think I need that just yet. Sprint shoes I'm not too worried about. But what you can do here is you can come up to this guy's bed and rest for free rather than spending money at the inn. Just walk into this poor guy's bedroom. Yeah, thanks for letting me sleep in your bed. We need to change those sheets now. Right, but that's pretty much everything you can do in Mobblers. Very small place. But what the main thing you need to do is get dried meat from the item shop. Because that's important for getting a hold of a certain young hide-draped young boy on the felt. That's pretty much the only thing that you need to get from this place. Better armor if you can afford it. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to end the stream here because I'm out of time for this video today. And in the next stream, which is going to be tomorrow night at 7 o'clock in the evening UK time, we will be streaming some Dark Souls. So close to the end of that game, but might even finish the DLC next stream. Maybe even the entire game, who knows? Because I've got 3 bosses left. 3 hours, 3 bosses. Is it possible? I don't know. We'll find out. And then on Tuesday evening at 7 o'clock UK time, We will be streaming some Bioshock Infinite. So yeah, you've got plenty to look forward to as the week continues. But for now, let's see if there is anyone else streaming that might benefit from an raid. Let's have a look. Twitch. Who is online? Fi-Fi TV. Velatronic. That's a no-brainer, isn't it? Give Vel some love. Give him some photos. Give him some attention. Give him everything you can because this guy deserves it. But yeah, that's it for me. Thanks so much for spending your morning and a bit of your afternoon with me. I really appreciate it. And I'll see you all in the next stream.